While the popular upcoming list on Steam is a great place for developers to get their games noticed on the front page, the system might be causing more harm than good. The issue was brought up by No More Robots, Mike Rose, a former Gamasutra editor, who explained how the feature could potentially be manipulated, intentionally or not, by developers to create an unfair advantage. Steam takes the release date for each game set in the Steam backend, and then lists all the titles with a fair amount of wishlist numbers, in order of when they are supposedly coming out. Rose points out that this is where manipulation can come in. Here's the thing, you can set any date for your game's release in the Steam backend, and it means nothing. He writes, you can set a date, and let it go by. Then you can set another date, and let it go by again. Setting this date has no meaning except for appearing in the upcoming list. Developers could manipulate the system so their game shows up over and over on the upcoming list, leaving titles which are actually coming out soon to be pushed back from the list on the front page. He lists Steel Division 2nd as an example. This is a genuine issue, because as we all know, having your title on the front page of Steam, even in an upcoming list, can be a big deal for wishlist sales. Rose continues, if the upcoming list does not actually show upcoming games, it hurts other developers. Tom Giardino, who works on the Steam business team at Valve, chimed in on the set that it's an issue the company is aware of and wants to fix. This was a big topic of discussion yesterday, and it frustrates us for the same reasons it frustrates you. But it's also super important that devs get to control their own release timing, so we do not want to mess with that. Giardino said, I am very wary of making promises or setting incorrect expectations. But we also care about this, and are trying to fix it in a way that makes upcoming releases more valuable without hurting games that wish to shift their release date. Only time will tell if the system will be tweaked or not. It's hard to learn how to be a good leader in the game industry. Luckily, at DD2012 Bunny, as Brian Sharp, gave a great talk about how to lead well by doing two things, communicating effectively and maintaining perspective. Conversations obviously bear meaning on many levels beyond explicit words, and in his talk Sharp explored the assumptions and context with, consciously or otherwise, used to frame interactions. Skillful framing is worth practicing, as it can inspire, motivate and energize, helping you navigate the shores of professional power dynamics, and strengthen important relationships. Sharp's talk on the subject was both approachable and rich in practical lessons. So if you did not catch it live, make sure to watch it now. That is, freely to watch on the official DD YouTube channel. In addition to this presentation, THEGDC Vault and its accompanying YouTube channel offers numerous other free videos, audio recordings, and slides from many of the recent game developers' conference events. And the service offers even more members-only content for DD Vault subscribers. Those who purchased all access passes to recent events, like DD, Vertical already have full access to DD Vault, and interested parties can apply for the individual subscription via DD Vault subscription page. Group subscriptions are also available. Game-related schools and development studios who sign up for DD Vault Studio subscriptions can receive access for their entire office or company by contacting staff via THEGDC Vault group subscription page. Finally, current subscribers with access issues can contact DD Vault technical support. Gamasutra and DD are sibling organizations under parent company Informa. Zach Barth, announced the creation of a KICKSTARTERCAMPAIGNERALIER today to help fund a book filled with design documents from all of Zachtronics games, as well as unreleased titles, titled Zach-like. This collection could be a neat opportunity for fellow developers interested in learning about the behind-the-scenes for multiple games, including Shenzhen 901 XPEX, according to the Kickstarter campaign, which has already exceeded its $5,000 goal. The book does not contain much narrative history or any theories of game design, but should be thought of as a record of the Zachtronics design process in action. The 500-page book is also estimated to contain 90% pictures and 10% text, as explained in the campaign. After everyone who backs the project receives a physical copy of the book, Bart intends to release a PDF for free at some point as well. Interested developers can check out the Kickstarter for Zach, like here, in the CD Europe 2016 talk. Antinodes Christian Divine reflects on the writing and design process for Life is Strange, and how its development heralds a new era for narrative games. Divine discusses how the acceptance of Life is Strange among players was a sign that game narratives are expanding, and the new age has become a blue age of storytelling. It was an insightful talk that's definitely still worth watching, so developers should not miss the opportunity to do so now that it's freely available on the official GDU Tour channel. In addition to this presentation, THEGDC Vault and its accompanying YouTube channel offers numerous other free videos, audio recordings, and slides from many of the recent game developers' conference events. And the service offers even more members-only content for GD Vault subscribers. Those who purchased all access passes to recent events, like GD, Vertical already have full access to GD Vault, and interested parties can apply for the individual subscription via GD Vault subscription page. Group subscriptions are also available. Game-related schools and development studios who sign up for GD Vault Studio subscriptions can receive access for their entire office or company by contacting staff via THEGDC Vault Group subscription page. Finally, current subscribers with access issues can contact GD Vault Technical Support, Gamasutra, and GD as sibling organizations under parent company Informa. Cosmic Top Secret is an unusual game, about as close to non-fiction as video games get. Games like the Cold War board game Twilight Struggle may seek to simulate historical events, but Cosmic Top Secret, in an abstract and whimsical way, is autobiographical. Produced by Copenhagen-based film and game studio Classy Film, Cosmic Top Secret recounts the experience of game director Chun Lier as she discovers her parents' role in the national security of her country of Denmark. Lier's background in game development goes back to the 1990s as an animator and established her own company, Cosmic Top Secret co-producer Those Eyes, in 1998. Here's Larry her own words on the topics of storytelling in games, personal journeys, and game design. Cosmic Top Secret is produced by Classy Film, and co-produced by Those Eyes, hence it's probably more like a joint venture taking advantage of our different backgrounds and mutual interest in telling IU stories, if possible as video games. We met at the conference Nordic Game 7 years ago, when we were both scouting for business partners and possibilities in the cross-media area. Games are by many still considered to be a waste of time, and that's what we are humbly aiming to change with Cosmic Top Secret. By working with serious matters that are usually dealt with in film, literature, art, graphic novels, etc. At the same time, they totally honor games as a suitable form, if not better than any other media to tell this particular, far as important, story about being estranged from one's origin. It is about both, in terms of the history of the Cold War and my parents' role in that, what we call, the big circle, and, the little circle, about my personal relationship with my parents. You may ask, why does it need to be personal? It's because we believe it's through honest and detailed descriptions of other people's lives that will reflect on and evaluate our own life. We believe those kind of themes can be dealt with both via mechanics involving your body more directly than a film can, and via regular story elements. For us, a personal experience was quite suitable as the backdrop for an investigative game, where you have to explore and put bits and pieces together to form a bigger picture, where you the player, to a certain extent,